So we met a couple of years ago. Surprisingly or not, we got along. We had like an interesting rapport. And so we decided to do a book together.
Right.
And what I do when I write a book, whether it's about power, seduction, or war, I take the most powerful people in their field and I kind of break them down. I figure out what is the essence of them, what's the core of their success. I call it their power center of gravity. Right. So I decided I would do that with you. And so after a couple of months of following you around, I decided that the secret to your success, your power center of gravity, is your fearlessness. So in any kind of situation where you're interacting with people, you're the one that has less fear than they do. And that gives you like a constant strategic advantage. You're able to adapt to the situation, to take risks when other people are afraid of it. And this is, to me, the source of your power. And so this is the subject of our book, The 50th Law, the power that anybody can have in life if they assume this fearless approach. So I was wondering, were you just sort of born this way? Did you come out of the womb not crying, kind of fearless? Or did you have to develop this attitude when you were on the streets as a kid without a mother or father there? Did you have to learn how to be like that?
That's absolutely something that I developed
over
time. Because like, I think I have the same emotions everyone else does. I just have a way to suppress those feelings in different circumstances and situations. I can kind of adjust.
Can you remember a moment when you were afraid when you were a kid on the streets or you were hustling or anything?
A lot of moments when I'm afraid. I think it's necessary for you to have fear to be conscious of people.
Mm-hmm. What do you mean by that?
A slight bit of actual fear is necessary for you to be aware, like a paranoia. It heightens your awareness.
Right.
You know, so a lot of times when people, when I interact with people in different spaces, it's so less intense than what I've had to experience prior to music that it puts me in a space where it's really a relaxed space. So it is true. A lot of times I interact with people and they have a stronger fear factor involved in our interaction than I have because I've been in way worse situations, to me, more dramatic spaces. So I just look at each one of the situations and kind of analyze it, or I'll use a parallel to something I've experienced in my past to make sense of the actual situation. So a lot of the decisions are kind of like gut feelings. Like the music business and entertainment in general, there's no school for it.
Right.
You know, so you got to kind of instinctively make the right decisions and be spontaneous and not be afraid to actually be yourself in different ways. Like I've interacted with artists that have great talents in different spaces. They're amazing. They can do things that I can't actually do, but they can't beat me at being me.